We have been pretty blessed this year in the fall to have composer David Gillingham write a piece to celebrate this beautiful building and to have him in residency on our campus for 2 days with help and support through funding from our chapter of Kappa Kappa Psi. And tonight we are thrilled to welcome another composer to UMHB. She was with us yesterday during our rehearsal on this piece, Out of the Shadows, Love Shines. Again, through the support of the Mulanda chapter of Kappa Kappa Psi, we are extremely grateful for their generosity towards our band program and the instrumental music here and supporting new works for wind band. It's an important thing that we do for our medium, and I'm thrilled that our students feel that there's an important need to contact good composers and have them write beautiful music for us. Please, to give a brief introduction about what you're about to hear, please welcome Ms. Joni Green.
Where is she not here?
Out of the Shadows, Love Shines is a piece about community, specifically the type of community that we all share with our closest friends and those we love. This community was very important for one young man named Blake Brockington. He went to a high school called East Mecklenburg in North Carolina, and his community was his band. And unfortunately, he passed away a few years ago. He took his life, and his band remembered him by commissioning the work that you're about to hear this evening. Now, this piece, while sad, is also celebratory in that it evokes love at every step. It tries to show how each instrument in the ensemble really is there for Blake. I had the opportunity to speak with a few of Blake's friends and watch a documentary about Blake and read about Blake. And one thing that I learned about him more than anything is that he was a very loving person and kind person and accepting person. And his dream was for everyone to have love and give love. So the number one thing with this piece is to show that support was given to him even in a time when he couldn't give it to himself. So the piece starts out very slow and will maintain slow throughout. However, the pacing is really set in a way that we're getting towards the end of the piece in this sensitive, evoking manner, this beautiful sensitivity that the ensemble can give to Blake. So each instrument, as it enters, it's this idea of holding Blake's hand, and the color of each instrument as it comes in is very pure. And by pure, I mean you're going to hear one instrument at a time. And that is each close friend of Blake's taking his hand. And one thing that makes this piece special is each entrance has to be very controlled. And that is something that each player has worked very hard on, and it shows. It's very lovely. And yesterday, I actually didn't have too much to work on because they've done such great work already. But they come in very carefully, and then I would say the music blooms. And by bloom, I mean it crescendos. There's a melodic idea that happens, and then it decrescendos, and then another instrument comes in, and that's the idea of that next person taking Blake's hand. And we continue in this manner as each instrument has a moment to shine and continue walking with Blake as we pace through the piece. So along with pacing through the piece, there's also the idea of Blake himself. Blake played two instruments. In addition to being drum major, he played bassoon and euphonium. So I featured the bassoon and the euphonium. And the idea is that structurally, as a composer, I sit down in the beginning of the writing process and I come up with an idea of how the piece is going to work, kind of like a roadmap, if you think about it that way. And so the first part of the piece is worked out as far as the bassoon line can unravel, and then it really develops more as a euphonium can take over towards the end of the piece. But the idea of Blake having both parts is there all along. So when the bassoon in the beginning has more feature part of Blake. You're going to hear in the background there's still some euphonium. And then the euphonium is going to really come in stronger, and there's going to be some chord changes and a nice big euphonium solo. But then you're going to hear some bassoon behind that because Blake is both instruments. And then I really want to just point out the very end of the piece. In each player's part, it says cradling, and you're going to notice this because there's going to be a shift in the music. There's going to be this eighth note repetition and the percussion that is very much like a parent holding their child in this cradling idea, and the flute is going to have this melody that is the idea of this just, I guess, sadness, we can say. We can also say maybe settled for Blake. It's the moment where all of the hands of the ensemble come together and they can say their goodbye to Blake. So I hope you enjoy Out of the Shadows, Love Shines. Thank you.